I pitched a story about charity fights and white collar fighters, and instead of just writing the story, I said I thought it would be a lot better if I actually just participated in the event. So I ended up training to fight, fighting in Madison Square Garden, and that article became the book Amateur, which is not just the question of why men fight, but a lot of similar related questions I had around masculinity, like what does it mean to be a real man? Am I a real man? The ways I'd been socialized when I started my transition at 30, I wanted to re-examine all of them and make sure that I was co-signing, you know, with every single thing that I was, you know, doing in the world. Because I think younger men don't really, you know, when you're 13 years old, you don't really get that opportunity to have your frontal lobes and think about what you're actually doing. So I thought as an adult, I could make sure that my masculinity was a masculinity I was proud of. It was a really powerful experience to work really closely with men to become a better fighter. When I was training with guys in the ring, they were helping me see the ways I was afraid or the ways that I was hiding things about myself that I needed to bring out. So yeah, it was deeply intimate and really powerful and not at all like I expected.
Ladies and gentlemen, Thomas McBeast McBeast!
One of my favorite parts about the actual experience of fighting was entering Madison Square Garden. I think I didn't totally grasp what was happening until I was walking towards the ring and the spotlights were, you know, swinging all over and my fight song was playing. All along, I'd really been struggling with this idea of coming forward or, you know, wanting to hit another person in the face. Over time, it became easier, but it wasn't something that I was, I found in myself like this deep passion for doing ever. We're organisms and we respond really intensely to our environments, and we all know that just from being in the world. So the environments we're creating together are shaping our bodies, and I think that was the most powerful thing I learned in this book, that like as a culture we're collectively creating these expectations that then we're saying are problematic, so we need to change them as a culture. I've talked to a lot of trans folks and female boxers and even male boxers, cis male boxers, who are just who have found fighting as a way to work through things, and I think it's inspiring to them to know that that someone like me, who, you know, in some ways many people would say I had no business being in that situation, people who are transphobic would say that, and I think being able to overcome that, you know, that prejudice and do it anyway is something I'm really proud of.